Very good morning, students. In today's video, we will discuss chapter number 7, that is safety and first aid. Now, when we talk about the safety and the first aid usually comes when we met with an accident. Now, we know that accidents are very fatal. What happens when a person meets with an accident? Either the person loses his or her life, or he is responsible for taking away someone's life, or it might be possible that one of the two might get physically handicapped for lifelong. So, in order to remain safe everywhere, we have to follow certain safety norms. Now, in this video, we will discuss certain safety norms that are vital for keeping us safe. If we are following those safety norms, it means that the chances or the probability of keeping us safe is more. Now, the very first thing is inside the house, because danger is everywhere. When we are inside the house, it doesn't mean that the danger has been eliminated out 100%. No, there are certain places inside our home also where we have danger. Like if we are talking about two places, two prominent places is one is the kitchen. Why kitchen? Because kitchen is a place where we get a lot of food. Our mother prepares a lot of food for us. But it also has certain sharp objects that are placed there in the form of knife and other things. Now, usually what happens here is the children are not aware about the lethalness of these objects, the sharp objects that are placed there. If they somehow catch those sharp objects like knives and others, fork even, for an example, they might injure themselves or they might injure the other person as well, knowingly or unknowingly, right? Next thing is when we are talking about the kitchen, never allow children to run inside the kitchen because there are a lot of things that are placed in the kitchen. They may fall on them, causing them injuries. Next thing is that we have to keep in mind while we are working in a kitchen is that all the hot objects, all the hot utensils in which we have prepared food or boiled or milk and other things, they should be kept at such a place where it is not easy for a child to touch them. Never allow any hot substance to be stirred by a child because they don't know the art of stirring the things, right? Other thing is that when we are working in a kitchen, it is for everyone, especially for the elders, because elders are preparing food. When any elder is working in a kitchen, they should always wear cotton clothes, not synthetic ones. Why? Because synthetic clothes like nylon, rayon and others, they catch fire easily. Right? On the other hand, if a person is wearing cotton clothes, they do not catch fire easily. So it is better that you always wear cotton clothes. The next place is of danger is what? It is bathroom. Why? Because majorly it is slippery. Lot of water is being sprinkled every now and then. Right? Because of the wet floor, the chances are that the person, if is unaware of it, might fall down and hurt or injure himself or herself. So that is about the bathroom. Next thing is that when we are talking about the bathroom, there are utensils like gas geyser or electric geyser. Children should not be allowed to operate them. Why? Because they might injure themselves. So if it is an electric geyser and there is wet, floor is wet and the child is not wearing slippers, dry slippers, then there might be a chance that he or she might get an electric shock from the geyser, electric geyser. In case of a gas geyser, if there is any kind of a leakage, the child will not be able to identify that change inside the bathroom because of that gas, and that might also lead to a fatal accident. Next thing, when we are talking about the bathroom, it is that there are certain chemicals that are also kept inside the bathroom in order to clean the floor or the toilets. So they are harmful chemicals, right? So they should be keep out of reach of the children. Now, it is about the inside of the houses. Now, when we talk about the outside the houses, There are a lot of places. Well, we are talking about the outside the houses. Like safety in the playground. Like safety in playground. While we all know that children love to play in the playground and they normally visit the playground for enhancing their skills. Not academic skills, but playing skills. Now, when they are playing in the playground, what usually happens is there is a fight between the children, and that fight might result in an injury. So, what we have to do? We have to show sportsmanship while we are playing in the playground. Next thing is that we do not have to push each other. Usually what happens, the children used to push each other while they are playing. Right? It's my turn. No, it's my turn. Both of them are pushing each other. So it might lead to an injury. So do not push each other while you are playing in a playground. Next thing is that we should not play rough games. What are the rough games? Rough games are that someone is running and all of a sudden you stick out your leg and the person falls down, or the child falls down trembling down on the ground. That is a rough game. Foul game. Right? We should not be physical with each other in the playground or on the pitch or off the pitch. That is very important while we are playing in the playground. Next thing is that we have to wait for our turn. Maximum fight that occurs inside the playground is because of the turn. As I have already said, that no, it's my turn. The other person says, no, it's my turn. And what happens? Within a minute, the physical fight takes place between the two and all of the people. Either they are trying to pull each other apart or they are also involved in that fight. Right? Next thing is that while we are swinging, we are playing on a swing. We should not swing too high for the other person to fall down from the swing. Normally what happens, the person pulls forward or pushes backward to a certain extent and with extreme force they release it. So what happens? It might be possible the other person might get off balance and fall down from the swing, which might lead to an injury. Right? So that is even in the seesaw and the swings. Next thing is when we are returning home from the playground, it should always be before the dark. Because during the playground, during the darkness, what happens? There are a lot of insects that might come out. Snake and other venomous insects that might come out and might bite you unknowingly. Right? So it is always better that you reach your home before the dark. Right? Another thing, important thing is that when we come back to the house, what we have to do first thing? We have to move straight to the bathroom. Why? In order to wash our hand, feet and face. That will eliminate out all the germs that have stuck to your arms or legs or on your face. So that will prevent from any type of a disease also. So that was about the safety in the playground. Next topic is safety in the swimming pool. Safety in swimming pool. Now, when we are talking about the safety in the swimming pool, normally there are two type of people. One who are well versed in the art of swimming and the other person who doesn't know the art of swimming at all. So the person who doesn't know the art of swimming, we should never ever try to throw him or her inside the pool. Right? First thing. Second thing, when we are talking about the swimming pool, that when we are entering the swimming pool, there should be a person who is properly trained. And we should always swim in presence of a person who is properly trained. Right? So, that is very much essential. That training from an expert should be there while you are swimming in a pool. Especially if you are a beginner. Next thing is that when we are trying to swim, we should always swim at a shallow end. Not at the deep end. Why shallow end? Because it will be easier for you to jump up. Right? On the shallow end, what will happen? You will get drowned. Right? Next thing is that when we are swimming, swim only at the spots that are appropriate as per the safety norms. Like some of you how well versed you are in swimming. But when you are swimming in a river that is having a current, flowing water, and when you are swimming in a pool that is having a stagnant water, there is a huge difference in swimming in the two conditions. So when you are swimming in a running water, in a river that is having a lot of water in it, only swim at those places where there is a board marking. Never try to exceed that point. Why? Because you not know how much deep that place is. Right? So these are the few safety norms that you have to keep in mind while you are inside the home, especially when you are in kitchen or in bathroom. And outside the houses, we have taken 2 points, that was safety in the playground and safety in the swimming pool. Next of the points will be discussed in the next video. Thank you.